Hi, in this video module, we are going to discuss economic development and a nation. Why economic development is required for any nation? So-called governments thrive for economic development of the nation as a part of enhancing the quality of life of the citizens. See, in that context, so this module is meant for understanding the nation and economic development, right? So if you just see the purpose of this module, this is to understand the essence of economic development for a nation. So if the economic development is happening in any nation, how it is going to reflect in the economic system as well as reflection even in the life of the citizens of the nations. So in that context, we will try to understand this small concept by just taking the support of a couple of slides. If you see the nation and then economic development, the most resources rich regions the world over are poor, right? Most resources rich regions the world over are poor, and resources poor regions are rich. We call it the resources curse phenomenon. So sometimes what happens, though we have the resources and abundant resources, enormous the value of resources, but even the nation is not developed. But in some countries you will find the resources are less, but the nation is the developed. So this is a kind of resources the curse that you can see. So this phenomena, you can see that underdevelopment is not because of lack of the natural resources, but because of deficiency in the combining the process itself that is undertaken by entrepreneurs. So how the resources are used, how resources value identified and then converted them as economic the goods and services with a kind of the value enhancement, and then how it is actually transferred to the end users, and then the benefit at the end the end customers are gained, and as a result, so what is the outcome from all these cyclical activities. So in that context, you can see that the resources, resources utility and resources identification, that is the most important part in between the nation, economic development and then entrepreneurship. The capital and then technology are fertile till the absorptive capacity of the country is adequate because of the shortage of skills or an attitude which favor the change. You can see that entrepreneurship is one important aspect. It depends on the society and the individual and the group of people who are actually looking at all these resources and then using those resources for the economic activities. As a whole, you can see the development that happens in the nation. So in this the perspective, if you see further, the free enterprise system, slightly we have just described in the previous module. So it is something related to what is the primary incentive of the free enterprise. So it is something related to the concept of profit, right? So money that is left over after all expenses of running a business have been deducted from the income. So when you see that enhancement of the value of the resources because of the conversion and then creation of the goods and services, so that enhanced value, some extent end user is enjoying or getting benefited out of it, and then service providers are also getting the surplus in the name of the profit, and then that is going to the accumulate the wealth in the individual side, and then that helps further advancement of the economic activities in the cyclical manner. In the process, you can see economic and then enterprise, so it is something related to what entrepreneurs are contributing, it is something related to all we have been discussing about the providing jobs and then the promoting change in the society and then create more wants and then turn the demand into the supply. So you can see all these are various aspects that are there as the main elements in between the economic activities and entrepreneurs. So when entrepreneurs are involving as intervention economic activity, so you can see that there is a creation of employment and then goods and services are created and then so there is a generation of demand and then there are suppliers. So in the process what happens, the people are just enhancing their the lifestyle and then improving the quality of life. So in all these respects you can see the advancement of the society at large. So further, if you see the government policy in this aspect and then government as a unit, and there is a causal relationship between the entrepreneurial development and then economic growth, because here the government policy, government support and the government involvement is an important aspect here. So therefore the government policy should support more entrepreneurial developmental activities so they will just take up various activities in the economy and in different the domains, and then use the resources which are there in the nation, including the natural resources, and convert them as products and services, and then see that there is a consumerism is created, and then the people are the purchasing capacity is increasing because they are getting employment, and then they want to consume more, and then they want to have more and more with them as a part of a necessity or as a part of luxurious life lifestyle. So in all the process what happens, the society at large is going to develop and then improve in all conditions because of intervention of the entrepreneurs in the economic system. And then you can see that resources which are actually underutilized and not utilized, so those are very much utilized in the system, and then in the process you can see that the nation is going to be developed because of the resources utilizations, so in the utmost manner. And at the same time, to support all these activities, the government the policy is a very important aspect, and then so that is a support to the policy, and then encouraging and providing different type of the schemes to encourage the entrepreneurs to start their ventures, to see that as a whole there is the huge impact on economy, and that as a result is going to develop the nation, and because of entrepreneurs and intervention in the economic system, and that is going to lead the entire advancement of the society, right? So with this, let me stop here, and then looking forward to meet you in the next video module. So thank you very much.